Feel I'm in a mood for a switch up.
Welcome to the very first edition of 2021 of Today's Talk with Marti G. It is me, Marti G, and I have my first guest of 2021 with me. It is my brand new friend, Jane Kemmerzell. Hi, Jane. How are you today?
Hi, Marti. I'm doing great. Thank you.
I really am glad that you could join me. I mean, I have to admit, you are a brand new friend. You're like my very first brand new friend of 2021. We have a mutual friend in common, right? So Joshua introduced us to one another, and we just kind of like hit it off like that.
Yes, absolutely.
So I definitely appreciate you taking time to be on. I really want to know a little bit more about what you do. So why don't you tell us the name of your business and what it is you do?
Okay. The name of my new business is Great Teams International. And what I do is help businesses to bring out the best in themselves. And I do that through diversity and equity and inclusion training, communication and leadership. All of those things go together to help people actually just plain get along better. And that's my goal, is to help businesses thrive and help people feel like they want to come to work and they have something to contribute and it makes a difference.
So I'm going to ask you the really tough question, because I'm just going to put it on the table. You don't look really diverse. And so how challenging is that for you to be able to teach diversity training? I mean, that's got to be a tough one, right?
You know, I think it is. And so I come from the standpoint that I know I'm white.
I know I'm not. I didn't say that. I said you weren't diverse. I didn't play the race card. I promise I didn't.
But you know what? Sometimes white people can hear things easier from other white people. Sometimes, not always, but sometimes. Right? And my point is to help bring out information that people can learn and reflect for themselves. So I'm not the know-all, be-all, do-all. I'm a facilitator. What I want to do is help create that safe space for people to feel like it's okay to not get this, but I want to try and I want to not feel stupid trying. And so that's what I want to do. I want to help create that space and gently bring people along, because in Oregon, we have a pretty big need for this.
Yeah, I mean, I tell you, I've learned a lot since I've been here. What made you think, because what were you doing before this? I think you said you were doing some sort of insurance or something, right?
Yeah, I was a commercial insurance agent for many, many years working with businesses. Mm-hmm. And so I was driving the back roads of Oregon to factories, to sawmills, to different, you know, manufacturing agricultural plants. Mm-hmm. And working with the businesses, I realized, you know, you look around and there's not a whole lot of people that don't look like me out there.
Right.
And a lot of that's the labor pool. However, it's also people hire people they're comfortable with. Well, that's great as long as that's all you have to draw from. However, our society is changing and we've got great potential employees that don't look like me that I think our employers should have, they're going to need to have. And I want to help them get ready for that. And I want to help them create that environment. So that way, when those people of color and of different cultural backgrounds come into their organization, they feel welcome and they know that they're a contributor.
Right. I mean, we were talking about this a little earlier the other day about the younger folks coming up, and you had mentioned something about how that's changed the dynamic or the population. Talk a little bit more about that, how just people have changed a little bit that are going into the workforce.
Yeah. So what I read, and I will cite the source when I can bring it up, is that as of 2021 in America, people ages 21 and under are now the majority non-white. So what this means is that your workforce coming in, most of them are not going to be white. This is in the United States, not in Oregon, but it's in the United States. However, the fastest growing ethnic community in Oregon is the Latinx community. Mm-hmm. And there's a lot of really well-qualified applicants out there that businesses need to embrace.
So what do you think some of the difficulties that you would run into? You know, because this is more of a niche. I haven't seen a lot of folks do what you do. So what do you think some of your biggest hurdles would be going into this type of a business?
people going, I don't need that. We're fine. We got who we want.
If it ain't broke, don't fix it.
Exactly. So, since I've been around businesses long enough, and I've been that insider with many of these business owners, and I know that hiring and retention is a big issue for them, and productivity. And so, if you're having a problem finding potential applicants, you need to expand your pool. Usually the biggest barrier they cite is we can't get anybody that can pass a drug test. Well, there probably are, if you expand your pool, there are communities where maybe you can get people that can pass a drug test. And the drug thing is a whole different conversation. Right. But my point is to help the business owners expand their thought process and their recruiting tools to people that maybe English isn't their first language. And it doesn't mean they can't learn or they can't speak English. Many of these people do speak English. It's just you're not as comfortable when you know that, maybe there's a barrier. Well, if you want to get those orders out on time and you need people in your firm, you better adapt to what the needs are going to be.
Well, I mean, it's something that I think has always been a challenge for me, just on the other side, because I've been in business most of my life after, the military and then college and then getting in. It's the whole cultural dynamic of who I am. Us African-American folks, we're very emotional people, just by nature. We're very emotional folks. And it tends to be a drawback a lot of times. And it's kind of unfortunate because it's kind of a negative attribute that's kind of played against us in some certain factors. It's like, oh, you're just an angry Black man. No, I'm just passionate. I'm trying to get my point across and I'm taking it pretty serious. Why do I have to be an angry Black man to get my point across? Can I just be passionate about it? I mean, and it's weird because when I did debate in high school, I did Lincoln Douglas debate, I'd never had anybody on the other side of the table say, you're just an angry Black man. I don't like your point. No, they just went right back and forth with me like a regular debate. But it just seems as things have become, and maybe it's more north and west that I've gone, that it just seems to be more apparent to me. So it's interesting to have someone in your position that does these things. Do you work with minorities as well that express some of these things?
Yes. I don't know if I want to classify as work with. I have many friends that are of color. Okay. In fact, I have family members that are of color.
Oh, right. Yeah, that's right.
My grandma is African American. So I have a whole family that we can have some great conversations with. And these conversations began a long time ago. And I grew up in Southern California, in Riverside, where it was one of the earliest integrated school busing communities in the U.S. And our school was so integrated, we didn't need busing. So I lived next door to Black people. My siblings' best friends were Black. This wasn't new territory for me.
As a matter of fact, I think you told me a story about your son, how he met his wife. How did your son meet his wife?
He met his wife in the Black Student Union when he joined.
Yeah, he went into a Black Student Alliance meeting, right?
I said, Paul, that's great. Tell me, how did people receive that? He goes, well, they're kind of wondering what I was doing there. But they also saw that I kept coming back.
Yeah, they probably thought he was a spy first, right? Thought he was like a plant or something.
Well, he said, Paul, it's open to everybody.
Yeah, it is.
And anybody can join. He goes, but most people just don't come back. Right. And I kept coming back. And so later, talking to several of his friends who are now my friends and our friends, they said, yeah, we couldn't figure out what he was doing. What's going on? And then they said, yeah. And when he started going out with Ariana, his wife, we're kind of going, whoa, she was new. She was newer to the school. And, they got together and now I've got three beautiful granddaughters. So,
yes, I met one earlier. Beautiful, beautiful child.
Yes.
So let me ask you, because I always try to find ways to help, because even though we're in the nature of COVID and it's kind of hard to do that, referral, I mean, we all know people do business with people they know, like, and trust. So I always try to find ways to help. I'm not necessarily out amongst people a lot. I'm working inside more, but how can I, or people that are watching this, how can we best help you? What's the best way to get you business or help refer you? What can we do to help you?
Well, thank you so much. I really appreciate that. I think by opening up doors for me to talk to business owners that want to have their employees get along better, that's usually the first thing. One of my key employee employers that I had as a former client said, you know, we've got two plants and we've got these management teams that they just don't get along. And she said, I brought them to a two-day diversity training. And it wasn't an issue with race or color, but it was just, they just weren't communicating. And she said, and we wasted our time and money. It didn't work. And so I told her, I said, well, you know, what I do is I'll come in and we'll do some training, but then we'll do this for a period of time. So it really is those people that want to make a change that's going to last, not just check off a box. Oh yeah, we did our training for this.
Yeah. That's always one of my frustrations is like, okay, we have to check the diversity box. So let's have a conversation about diversity. Okay, great. Now we're done. Are you really?
And you know, Marti, it doesn't even have to be the diversity training, communication training, leadership training. Okay. Those things all help employers. To me, they're like all three are on a wheel and you can get on at any point. But at some point, you cover all three if you're really going to move your organization forward.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Well, you know, I was talking to you earlier because I was trying to find backgrounds. I want to know a little bit more about, so I guess you've been all over the place, right? So tell me where's the most exotic place you've been? You've been all over the place. What is the most exotic place you've been?
Well, the place that's the most different from anything I've ever experienced before is definitely India and where I've gone in India. Because I've gone to India for 4 years straight with a group of people that help support people in India that are helping the poor. Now you think, oh, well, India, there's a lot of poor people. Yes, India has a caste system, which was outlawed in the 60s. And below the three major castes are 15 minus castes. And below that are the tribal people that don't count at all. Those are the people I visit. And they are lovely people. And seeing how they live and seeing what their life is like, it's very, very different, not only just to be there, but just to get to the places where we have to go to be there. So that would be probably the most different. But yet, you know what, Marti? There's so many similarities. Moms are moms, kids, really cute kids.
Right.
Dads are trying to put food on the table. They're just trying to survive. There's so much commonality.
So the dynamics are always going to kind of be the same, aren't they?
Yeah. And then the second place would be Guatemala, where I've gone with the medical team 8 times.
Okay.
And my role has been to go into the homes. This is in the rural highlands, and these are the indigenous Mayan people. So Spanish isn't their first language. And we go into their homes and we install large stoves. They're not something that they can carry off. They're something that require an insulation that takes several hours. And so I get to be in their homes, and the women don't really talk to the men on the team. It's a 4-person team, but they'll talk to me. And again, moms are moms. Kids are kids, and dads are dads.
So many
commonalities.
That's awesome. Yeah. And I think that helps because I think about the ability that I've been able to get. I used to really be angry with my parents when I was younger because they moved us around a little bit. And it actually helps when you think about what you do from a diversity standpoint. It actually helps to see different cultures. You learn a lot about different types of people and how to interact and engage people. I mean, literally, I could probably carry on a conversation with a blade of grass if I really needed to. Because there's probably no one I don't relate to. But I really do think what you're doing is phenomenal. If there's a way that I can keep boosting you, I will do what I can, folks. I definitely want you to get a hold of Jane. I'll have her contact information in the little comment section. Is there anything you would like to share with us before we go?
Well, I think what I want to share is don't be afraid of people that aren't like you, because people are people. You know, they usually put their clothes on one garment at a time, and they usually drink water, you know, just kind of like you do. And even if they don't, because their bodies are different, they're still people. And that's okay. And I just want to encourage people, if you can let go of a little bit of the fear, then you can be a whole lot more open to those around you.
Very wise, very wise words. Thank you so much, Jane. Again, reach out to Jane. Again, I'll have her contact information. And if, folks, you want to do a today's talk with me, I'm always looking for more people. So definitely that contact information will also be in the comments. Thanks a lot for tuning in. Jane, thank you for stopping by with me today. Say goodbye.
Well, I'm in the mood for a change up. I leave the city and return with my change up. They got amnesia, don't remember how they played us. They want to knock me down, but somehow I just stay up.
Straight to the stage, they love me. I understand they hungry, but please don't hate, that's ugly. I've been sliding, shaking, moving, I've been popping in my city. Shawty say she love the way we do it with me. I be too turned up to ever give a f. I ain't come to argue, let a n-
please, baby.
been talking pennies, I need bigger bucks. About to catch a flight, I need to switch it up. Got that black boy joy, might do my dance on him. Take no disrespect.